And girls, so we are going to talk about measurement today of weight. And so the first thing we want to do is see what words that we have with it. And so ounce is the smallest form of weight measurement in customary units, and it is called an ounce. And so it's abbreviated OZ. That doesn't look like anything in there. And just like we learned in our story, Frindle, of where Miss Granger was trying to teach them, words are important. They come from someplace. And so ounce comes from the English. It's actually a medieval Italian word of called onza. And so I think that's where, so you can see how they took the OZ out of it to make the abbreviation for ounce. Now, pound is another one that we got from the British, probably when all the settlers and that were coming over to the United States. And it actually comes from a symbol, which it looks kind of like an L, and it's called Libra. And so that's where they take out the LB for pound. And a pound is 16 ounces. And the last one, ton, comes from tun, which was used to measure barrels of wine back in the day. I see it oftentimes abbreviated with a T, but on them, it didn't really say anywhere that they have an abbreviation. So a lot of times you will see it just as T-O-N, but that's 2,000 pounds. So now we want to kind of understand what these measurements are. So the first one, if I'm thinking about an ounce, I'm thinking about a slice of bread. Whereas if I'm talking about a pound, then I'm talking about the whole loaf of bread. Well, now my loaf is not full right in there. So if it's each one is about 1 ounce, then there's about 16 slices of bread in there. And you can see on here of where it talks about its net weight is 16 ounces or it's 1 pound. We also see that in other foods that we're buying. Maybe you like hummus and you're in there. This too is in 1 pound. It's 1 pound, 1 ounce. So it's a little bit more. So that's why you see it's 17 ounces. Or you might have a box of noodles. Maybe you're wanting some mac and cheese tonight. And so on here, you might buy 1 pound of noodles, which is 16 ounces. But now, what if I go to something like this, of where there are in this one 32 ounces? Well, then it tells you it's 2 pounds because 16 plus 16 equals 32. So now, the last thing I want to do is so that you can see when you're measuring weight, you want to use a scale. And so I'm going to show you this scale and we're going to take a look at the parts on it. I'm going to try and make that a little bit clearer. Okay, so you can see on here of where it shows 0 up to 1 pound, 2, 3, and this one can go up to 7 pounds. That's the most that this scale can weigh. Now, if you go on your bathroom scale, obviously can weigh a lot more, but this is one that they might use in the grocery store and that. But now this kind of looks like our ruler that we were working with last week. And you can see that it is divided up into 4 parts. You see all those tiny little lines. So in between there, that's parts of the ounces. So you can have a half an ounce, 1 ounce, half, 1.5 ounces, two, and to oh, I'm sorry, I'm looking at it here. So there's only four. So each one of those little lines is about 1 ounce. So if I were to put this slice of bread, now I have to calibrate it first. So I'm going to try and turn this sideways so you can see. Let's see if I can get that worked out for you. Okay, so I'm going to calibrate it because this is the thing that you're watching to see if it'll move. Okay, so now when I put something on top of it, this has weight to it. And so I have to slide it so that it starts at 0. Otherwise, I won't get an accurate measurement. So now, if I were to put this slice of bread inside there, it moves just that little bit. So it is just about 1 ounce. Now, you might go to this grocery store and you might want to buy your apples. And so they sell them by the pound. Maybe it's $1.49 a pound. So if I were to buy one apple, Well, did it equal up to a pound? No, it's about a quarter of a pound, maybe a little bit more on it. So it wouldn't be $1.40. Now, why don't we even just say $1 a pound, make it easier. So this would be a little bit more than 25 cents. It's probably closer to 33. So let's see. Now, if I have two apples in there, I'm almost at a pound. If I have three apples in there, I can see I have about a pound and a half because I went, I'm trying to get that so you can really see on there. Boys and girls, I'm sorry. It's not working out quite as I would hope. But you can see I went past that one and now I'm up to about another half a pound. So these measurements are really good for us of when we're trying to weigh things and see how heavy they are. And if we're trying to buy food in that at the grocery store, or you're even trying to check out your own weight if you go onto a bathroom scale. All right, hope this helps you. And then there's another video with a little song to try and help you to remember the names for these. So good luck with that and your work or your big book page. Have a great day.